I suspect you.
I want to ask you a couple of questions just for my understanding and hopefully the audience understanding. You talked about the process a little bit, but I want you to walk us through when someone files a complaint and you determine that the complaint is meritless. You then notify them, I believe, in a hard copy or electronically or a phone call. How is that done?
Every complaint receives a written acknowledgement. Every complaint, when it is closed, receives an acknowledgement, which under the rules can say basically one of three things. The commission found an insufficient basis to proceed, or if, for example, a confidential disciplinary action was taken, the complainant is notified that there was an appropriate corrective action taken. If there's a public disposition, public discipline, or the case goes to formal charges, the complainant is informed of that, although they usually already know.
And if they're not happy with the response that you have issued, how do they go about appealing that, or what's the process that they can take this further in a path that is respectful for the average citizen?
Right. And complainants can continue to submit information. If a complainant, very often complainants will be asked for information, they don't provide it, they don't respond to the letter, so they're sent a closing letter. Anyone that submits further information, there's actually a place on the commission's agenda for each meeting that is called closed but additional information, and if individuals submit additional information, new information, it can be reconsidered.
And what's that process? How long does that usually take?
It all depends what's been submitted.
And if they're not happy, I'm trying to understand is that I'm hearing that some of these cases are just taking a long time. So I want to understand, how does someone that is tenacious and has the time and the ability to push the envelope so that they can get a response and get it in a timely manner, are there other avenues besides just what you've laid out that
Essentially, that's it. There's not a formal review process. I think that the process, complainants are not parties to a case against the judge. They're essentially a witness, providing a report and information. I think in very few states is there any formal appeal from a decision, to close a complaint.
So then let me ask you a follow-up question. How do you handle the review of judges who have had numerous complaints? And the second question to that is that if the judge is found, if there is no merit to the case, and someone else brings a same complaint or a different complaint on that particular judge, is that previous complaint that was found meritless brought into that current complaint? So my point is that if someone has a complaint and it's found meritless, and then there's two or three or four, do you take each one, or do you have past history that will come into that someone, the commission, can look at?
And that's an excellent question, because the commission often does not make a determination that something is meritless. The commission has a burden of proving things by clear and convincing evidence. Very often, for example, because we very rarely have recordings of court proceedings any longer, there are very rarely court reporters in most cases. So often the commission can't meet a burden of proof over what was said and done in a courtroom by clear and convincing evidence. If that complaint is closed and the judge receives another similar complaint, the commission is told at the outset of the new complaint that there have been additional complaints, unless it was disproven that there were additional complaints.
It
goes to the commission with each new complaint.
That there was another complaint.
Correct. Yes, they're told if there were a multitude of them that all involve the same type of allegation. It very often happens in small claims court, because we very typically have no record, no court reporting, no transcript of what took place in small claims court.
Okay, thank you.